Welcome to How to Become JD Edwards Functional Consultant channel. I am JP Parikh. The process and steps described is a lesson on configuration and setup of JD Edwards EnterpriseOne 9.2. If you like my video, please subscribe and share. Thanks for watching. Welcome. In earlier lessons, I have demonstrated how to set up accounts manually and copy accounts from one business unit to another business unit. When you create account manually one by one, it takes lot of time to add all accounts. Further, there are chances of errors during the creation of accounts. To import accounts into the JD Edwards EnterpriseOne general accounting system, you can upload account information from an Excel sheet. The Microsoft Excel sheet must include the required fields. For example, you must include object account, subsidiary, account description, level of detail, and posting edit code as shown in the Excel sheet. The MS Excel sheet should be in CSV format. Importing chart of accounts from Excel is very easy and increase efficiency and accuracy as well. Please keep in mind, if you import accounts from the accounts by object and subsidiary form, you are required to format the spreadsheet differently. To import chart of accounts from Microsoft Spreadsheet, follow these steps. From the EnterpriseOne homepage, click on the EnterpriseOne menus, followed by Financials, General Accounting, General Accounting System Setup, Organization and Account Setup menu, G09411 link, and then click on the Review and Revise Accounts link. A new form Work with Accounts will open. Alternatively, you can run Review and Revise Accounts program P0901 directly from the fast path to open Work with Accounts form. On the Work with Accounts form, click in the Business Unit field. Enter business unit number into the business unit field. Enter 1, then click Find button. You can see all the object accounts attached to Business Unit 1. Remember, you must have at least one object account in the business unit. Select first record from the grid that display object account 1000. Then click the Row Exit button. From the drop-down menu, click on the Account by BU menu. This will open Revise Accounts by Business Unit form. On the Revise Accounts by Business Unit form, click on the Business Unit field and enter business unit number where you want to import the accounts. For example, enter business unit number 19000. Click the Find button. The system does not display any results because no object account exists in the business unit 19000. Now, click the Tools button. From the drop-down menu, click on the Import Grid Data menu. On the Revise Accounts by Business Unit form, use Import Assistant to import data from a spreadsheet. In step 1, you should define import file. So, click the Browse button to locate the spreadsheet on your computer. Then, select the spreadsheet and click on Upload. Enter the file name into the worksheet name field. In this lesson, we shall be importing file named Chart of Accounts. In step 2, define cell range to import from the worksheet that was uploaded in step 1. Click in the Starting Cell column field, enter A. Click in the Starting Cell row field, enter 2. Please note, row 1 of the Excel sheet is heading, hence not included in the selection. Click in the Ending Cell column field, enter P. Click in the Ending Cell row field, enter 308. After defining cell range to import, click the Apply button. The system displays the spreadsheet data in grid. Make sure all column and row are displayed in the grid. Now, click the Continue button. On the Revise Accounts by Business Unit form, verify that all of the data has been uploaded successfully. Now, click the OK button to save the records in the database. the system stores accounts information in Account Master Table F0901. Click the Cancel button, then click the Close button to close Work with Accounts program. This is the end of the process of importing accounts by Business Unit.